In this video, I'll show you the steps to install Windows 11 on your Chromebook. Watch this video in full to understand each step before you try to modify your Chromebook. Step 1 is to check if your Chromebook is compatible. Check the stickers on your Chromebook to identify the model, or with your Chromebook turned on, click on the search icon on the taskbar and type chrome:// system and press enter. Scroll down to VPD 2.0 and click on expand to view the model of your Chromebook. I have an HP 11 Gen 6 EE. Now open an internet browser and search for the full specs of your Chromebook model and note it down. Note the processor down. I have an HP 11 Gen 6 EE with an Intel Celeron N3350 or N3450 processor. With this information, go to this website, coolstar.org. Click on Chromebook, select your Chromebook manufacturer and click Next. Select the processor of your Chromebook. I have an Intel Celeron N3350 or N3450 processor, so I'll select that. If your processor is not found, then your Chromebook is not supported to run Windows operating system. In my case, Windows 10 and 11 is supported. If you like to install Windows 10, check out my old video on how to install Windows 10 on a Chromebook. I'll leave the link in the video description below. One more thing to note on this website is click on the arrow beside developer mode and flash firmware and note down only the first line. You will need this info later. Before we jump to step 2, you will need two USB drives. One should be 8GB and above, and the second could be 2GB and above. We will use the large drive to create our Windows 11 bootable drive and the other to create our Chrome OS backup. Step 2, we are going to create our Windows 11 bootable drive. We can either create this online or offline. To create it online, type download Windows 11 in your browser and click on the first link. Click on download now under the Windows 11 installation media to download the media creation tool. Open the downloaded tool and run. Uncheck use the recommended options for this PC box to select your preferred language. Check USB flash drive and insert your 8GB drive and click Next. Refresh drive list if your drive isn't found. Click Next to start the Windows 11 bootable creation process. The progress will start from 0 to 100% after it is done, and the time could take minutes or hours depending on the speed of your internet. To create a bootable drive offline using the ISO image of Windows 11, click Windows 11 Multi Edition under the third option, which is download ISO file. Select product language and click confirm. Click on the 64-bit download to download the ISO file. After the ISO file is done downloading, open your browser and search for Rufus download. We will use this software to create the bootable drive offline. Click on the first link, scroll and download the standard version. Open Rufus, insert your 8GB pen drive, select it under device. Click on select and navigate to Windows 11 image directory and select it. Select GPT under partition scheme and click start. The status will change to ready when complete. Now to step 3, we will put our Chromebook into developer mode. This will wipe all data on your Chromebook, so create a backup of files you would like to keep. Press the escape, refresh and power button at the same time. Press Ctrl D, then enter. Press Ctrl D again. Your system will transition into developer mode. A 30 seconds timer will start and another 5 minutes timer will follow. Your Chromebook will restart after its process and two beeps sound will signal a successful transition into developer mode. Press Ctrl plus D to start your Chromebook OS, then shut it off at this point. Now let's go to step 4. We will disable write protection on our Chromebook. I mentioned at the end of step 1 in this video to note down some info from the coolstar.org under the developer mode and firmware. This information will help you determine the type of write protection your Chromebook uses. From my notes, I'll have to disconnect the battery to disable write protection. In your case, you might have to remove a write protection screw from your motherboard. The screw is usually unique compared to the other screws on the motherboard, and it usually has a flat top and WP symbol by it. Now in my case, I'll have to disconnect the battery, so I'll unscrew the back cover screws and disconnect the battery. Or in your case, you have to remove the screw. I'll disconnect the battery in my case and leave the screws behind, as I will reconnect the battery later. Now to step 5, which is downloading the utility script. With your charger plugged in, turn on your Chromebook, connect to a Wi-Fi and browse as guest. Press Ctrl Alt plus forward arrow. If you are using an external keyboard, which I recommend to use at this stage, press Ctrl Alt F2. Type Chronos as password, CHRONOS, and type these codes as you see it and press Enter. Beside FWP, which is Firmware Write Protect, it should show disabled. Now select the option Install Update UEFI Full ROM Firmware. This is option 2 on mine, it could be 1 or 3 on yours. Type Y and Enter. Now type I accept in caps and press Enter. Press Y to continue. Connect your 2GB or above USB drive at this point and press Enter to store your firmware backup. Press 1 and Enter to save it. Eject it after backup is down and then press Enter. The full ROM firmware download will start. Press Enter to return to main menu and P to turn the Chromebook off. I'll reconnect the battery and screws. Now to step 6, which is installing the Windows 11. Insert your Windows 11 bootable drive and turn on your Chromebook. Start pressing the Escape button on your keyboard immediately you turn it on to access the BIOS. Navigate to boot menu and select your bootable drive from the list. Select a language. Click I don't have product keys. I prefer Windows 11 Pro. You can select your preference. Accept the terms. Your internal drive is partitioned into several parts. You can click on each partition and delete, or simply press Shift plus F10 to open CMD. Type taskbar, DISKPART, and press Enter. Type list disk, press Enter. Type select disk 0, which is the internal drive. Type clean to delete all partitions. Now you can type exit to exit CMD. Click on the back arrow and then next arrow, or click next to view your internal drive and install Windows. Now that Windows is almost done, select your country, keyboard layout. I don't have internet and continue with limited setup. Windows 11 is now installed. Now let's go to step 7 and download the correct drivers for it. Make sure your external mouse is connected. As my touchpad isn't working, I'll connect to a Wi-Fi, and using the instructions in step 1, go to coolstart.org website and select your model of Chromebook. Download the available free drivers. In some cases, you have to purchase some of these drivers. After installing the free drivers, check for Windows update. This might also help fix some driver issues. After installing drivers and updating Windows, my touchpad, VGA, Bluetooth and other drivers is successfully installed, with the exception of my sound drivers. This sound driver is up for sale. This is the end of this tutorial. So maybe after installing Windows 11 on your Chromebook and you have finished using it for a purpose and you would like to revert to Chrome OS, check out this video that I made. I'll leave the link in the video description below. If you have any questions or need help in the process, you can leave it in the comment section and I'll reply. My name is Jessica, and for more tutorials like this, subscribe to my channel.